state, like, you probably don't believe it, but I believed, we've had the staff conversation from the beginning that this team had the potential to be a top two team in the league. And, you know, it took us a while to show that, for some things to settle out. But I would have been really happy to know that was what was going to happen. But, you know, I felt confident that this team had a mix of talent and character and heart to be able to accomplish big things.
When you were watching the sort of opening rounds shake out last night, how were you keeping tabs on it? You know, how were you trying to approach on the fly?
Well, I mean, I think we were making a calculated bet that it was likely that Providence won. I mean, that was if Providence won, then we knew that it would be Providence. I think Jess and I were watching the Providence Holy Cross game. Alex was watching the Merrimack UNH game just to make sure that everybody was keeping tabs on everything. And actually, Holy Cross put up a great fight. And I think it is a quick turnaround. Also, because we found out, you know, basically at 9 o'clock last night, and we had practice at 7 o'clock this morning, so we weren't going to have any time to do any major adjustments. And in a way, that's been kind of cool this week, just to focus on ourselves and not have it be like we've played all these teams at least three times, I guess, and some more recently than others. But I think, you know, at this point, you know, we default back to the let's focus 90% on us, 10% on the other team.
What does that, like, 60-something hours in between 7, 9 p.m. last night to game day, what does that now look like?
Really, it's just special teams, I think, is really the major thing that we would focus on, just making sure that our power play is prepared to play against their penalty kill, and our penalty kill is prepared to play against their power play. So I think that's probably really the major things. And tomorrow will just be a short day before the game practice, and obviously early game on Saturday. So kind of good that we don't have to sit around and wait for a night game. Yeah, I mean, that's, you know, we know that very well. The other thing about them is neither team has been at full strength when we've played any of the games against them. So we played them December 31st. We were missing a slew of people for COVID protocol reasons. And then when we played them, but they had their Swedish Olympian was playing in that game. Then she was gone, and our Olympians were gone when we played 3 weeks later. At home. So, you know, in that sense, both teams will be a little different, but, you know, I think we're just going to have to continue to have an attacking mentality and be able to score in different ways.
Going into the playoffs now, is it, you're no longer the underdog. You guys are, you know, expected to win. How do you kind of take that mentality?
Well, I mean, I think we were the higher seed last year. I just think we have a lot of confidence based on how we've played over the last couple of months, the adversity that we faced, the different ways that we can win games. And I think from a coaching perspective, it's best to just kind of, like, let's just keep to our process. Let's keep the way we practice, the rhythm of the week as normal as possible. And, you know there'll be a little extra excitement in the room for Saturday. But, you know, I think it's as much as possible. Just let's focus on doing what we need, playing the way we need to play.
How has it been making those adjustments now that your lineup is back full strength?
Well, we had Natalie Milinkova back for Saturday's game, so it took a couple periods. We were spotting her in different places, put her back on her old line for the third period, and actually it was a huge impact in the game. And, you know, having Sini back, and it seemed pretty seamless. She got in Sunday night, and she was at practice Monday afternoon. We took Tuesday off. She's starting to get back a little bit more to normal and talking to the Czech players. A few days later, they're starting to sleep a little better and get their biorhythms back. So, Yeah, I mean, I think the hardest part about it, honestly, is just impact on other kids who have played important roles for us all this, you know, over the last couple of months, really over the whole season. I can't think of, certainly not a team I've coached, there's got to be very few teams that have ever had seasons like we've had, where we've had three goalies play important roles. We've had, you know, important players that have been in the stands, like Cam Marcy didn't play a second last season in our short season, and has played a regular shift for a lot of games, scored huge goals, scored a huge shootout goal for us last weekend at BC. I think there's probably more of a gentle touch around that than a huge adjustment into like the way we play and where people fit in. I think the only thing really is the lingering memory is to play with the urgency, not to let the first period get away from us or take any time to settle into the rhythm of the game. I think we need to make the most of the 60 minutes. I think we maybe got away with it on the Saturday game at BC. We had a really lackluster first period and got better from there and an excellent third period. And I think that was a good reminder that we need to come out and play that way right from the start.